our government had taken up the major initiative for setting up an institute of eminence. There has been a tremendous response to this initiative by institutions in both public and private sector. We have received more than 100 applications. We have taken steps to set up a specialized railway university at Vadodara. We propose to set up two new full-fledged schools of planning and architectures to be selected on a challenge mode. Additionally, 18 new schools of planning and architecture would be established in the IITs and the NITs as autonomous schools, also on a challenge basis. The government would also launch the Prime Minister's Research Fellows scheme this year. Under this scheme, we would identify 1,000 best BTEC students each year from premier institutions and provide them with facilities to do PhDs in the IITs and the Indian Institute of Science with a handsome fellowship. It is expected that these bright young fellows would voluntarily commit few hours every week for teaching in a higher educational institution. Now I come to the health sector. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya is the guiding principle of my government. Only Swasth Bharat can be Smridh Bharat. India cannot realize demographic dividend without its citizens being healthy. I am pleased to announce two major initiatives as a part of the Ayushman Bharat program aimed at path-breaking interventions to address the health holistically in primary, secondary and tertiary care systems covering both prevention and health promotion. The National Health Policy 2017 has envisioned that health and wellness centers as the foundation of India's health system. These 1.5 lakh centers will bring healthcare system closer to the homes of the people. These centers will provide a comprehensive healthcare, including a non-communicable diseases and maternal and child services. These centers will also provide free essential drugs and diagnostic services. I am committing rupees 1200 crores in this budget for this flagship program. I am also invite contribution from the private sector through the CSR and the philanthropic institutions in adopting these centers. Madam Speaker, we are all aware that lakhs of families in our country have to borrow or sell assets to receive indoor treatment in hospitals. Government is seriously concerned about the impoverishment of the poor and the vulnerable families. Presently, the Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana provides an annual coverage of only rupees 30,000 to poor families. Several state governments have also implemented and supplemented health protection schemes by providing varying coverages. My government has now decided to take healthcare protection to a new aspirational level. Madam, this is important. We are now launching a flagship national health protection scheme to cover 10 crore poor and vulnerable families. This is approximately 50 crore beneficiaries by providing them up to 5 lakh rupees per family per year for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization. This will be the world's largest government-funded healthcare program. Adequate funds will be provided for smooth implementation of this program. Madam Speaker, 10 करोड़ परिवार यानी 50 करोड़ लोगों को 5 लाख रुपए प्रतिवर्ष हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन की सुविधा
ये सरकार उपलब्ध करवाएगी।
मैडम स्पीकर, दीज टू फार रीचिंग इनिशिएटिव्स अंडर आयुष्मान भारत प्रोग्राम will build a new India 2022 and ensure enhanced productivity, well-being and avert wage loss and impoverishment. These schemes will also generate lakhs of jobs, particularly for women. The government is steadily but surely progressing towards the goal of universal health coverage. यानी कि इस 50 करोड़ की जो सुविधा है उसको आगे भी एक्सपेंड किया जाएगा इस एक्सपेरिमेंट को देखने के बाद। ट्यूबरकुलोसिस क्लेम्स मोर लाइव्स एवरी ईयर देन एनी अदर इंफेक्शियस डिजीज। इट इफेक्ट्स मेनली पुअर एंड मैलनरिश्ड पीपल। माय गवर्नमेंट हैज देयरफॉर डिसाइडेड टू एलोकेट रुपीज 600 करोड़ टू प्रोवाइड न्यूट्रिशनल सपोर्ट टू ऑल टीबी पेशेंट्स एट द रेट ऑफ रुपीज 500 per month for the duration of their treatment. In order to further enhance accessibility of quality medical education and healthcare, we'll be setting up 24 new government medical colleges and hospitals by upgrading existing district hospitals in the country. This would ensure at least one medical college for every 3 parliamentary constituencies and at least one government medical college in each state in the country. Our resolve of making our villages open defecation free is aimed at improving the quality of life of our villages. We will launch a scheme called for galvanizing organic bio agro resources done Gobar Dhan for management and conversion of cattle dung and solid waste in farm to compost, fertilizer, biogas and bio CNG. The Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Bima Yojana has benefited 5.22 crore families with life insurance cover of 2 lakhs on payment of premium of rupees 330 per annum. Likewise, under the Prime Minister's Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, 13 crore 25 lakh people have been insured with personal accident cover of rupees 2 lakhs on payment of a premium of only rupees 12 per annum. The government will work to cover all poor households, including scheduled caste, scheduled tribe households, under these in a mission mode. The government will expand the coverage under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana by bringing all the 60 crore bank accounts within its fold and undertake measures to provide services of micro insurance and unorganized sector pension schemes through these accounts. Our commitment towards Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao is unflinching. Sukanya Smriti account scheme launched in January 2015 has been a great success. Until November 2017, more than 1.26 crore accounts have been opened across the country in the name of the girl child, securing an amount of rupees 19,183. Cleaning of Ganga is an important national importance, and it is our firm commitment that members will be happy to learn that the work is gathered speed. A total of 187 projects have been sanctioned under the Namami Gange program for infrastructure development and river surface cleaning, rural sanitation and other interventions at a cost of rupees 16,713 crores. 47 projects have been completed and the remaining projects are at the various stages of execution. All 4,465 Ganga Gram villages on the banks of the river have been declared open defecation free. To give focused attention and to achieve our vision of an inclusive society, government has identified 115 aspirational districts taking various indices of the development in consideration. The government aims at improving the quality of life in these districts by investing in social services like health, education, nutrition, skill upgradation, financial inclusion, infrastructure like irrigation, rural electrification, potable drinking water, and access to toilets at an accelerated pace and in a time-bound manner. We expect these 115 districts to become a model of development. Economic and social advancement of hard-working people of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes has received care and attention. Our government has increased a total earmarked allocation in the SCs in the 279 programs from ₹34,334 in 16-17 to ₹52,719 in 17-18. Likewise, for STs, the earmarked allocation was increased from ₹21,811 in 16-17 to ₹32,508 in the RE in 17-18 in the 305 programs. I propose to the earmarked allocation of 56,619 crore for SCs and 39,135 crore for STs in the BE of 2018-19. Government estimated schematic budgetary expenditure on health, education and social protection for 18-19 at 1.38 lakh crores against an estimated expenditure of 1.22 lakh crores in the BE of 17-18. Details are given in this expenditure. The expenditure is likely to go up by at least 15,000 crores in 18-19 on account of the additional allocations during the year and the extra budgetary expenditure including through the higher education financing agencies itself.